Welcome back to Magic Tarot Cards. It's Jasmine. I have a 9 card spread here for you. This is a request. One of my subscribers requested that I did this. I would kind of wish I had done it right away, but I didn't. This is for Robin Williams. He was the famous actor that committed suicide. And there was a subscriber told me that other people have been doing videos about him or did in the past. And she asked me if I would do it, so of course I'm going to do it. I meditated a lot today. I've been doing readings all day long, and so I've had a lot of energy here in my home. So I had to meditate, clear some of my energies out, so I could do this reading here. Don't forget, y'all, this video is not made for kids. If you're under the age of 18, please click off now. And please give me a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you'll be reminded when I upload another video. Y'all, this, I want to show you my cup today. This is from a website called Killstar. I absolutely love this cup. It says moonshine down here. This store, I saw it on Instagram, but this store actually sells stuff that's like for gothic people. I'm not into gothic or anything like that. Not that there's anything wrong with it, because there's not. I love some of their products, but I absolutely love this cup because of the stars and the moon. I love it. I love this cup. So I've had my hands on it, so it's kind of see my fingerprints. But I'm drinking a tea in here. And it's really big. I think it's not a 32 ounce, but it's more like a 24 ounce, I think, something like that. But anyway, the website is called Killstar. And if you go on there, you'll see a lot of nice things. All right. So that's what I'm drinking. I know it's not a paid advertisement. Okay, so back to my reading. Again, Robin Williams, the famous actor that committed suicide. I just want to pick up his energy. I'm not really asking any questions. Just pick up his energy and see what his thoughts and feelings are now that he's been gone a while and see what I get. So right away when I started shuffling, I picked up a lot of his energy. Some of it is dark. It's not dark because he was a dark person, but dark because of where he's at. Okay, so here we have the Hermit. So I'm right away seeing the state he was in, if I can pick this up, the state he was in for a long while. This is the Hermit. This is the person that goes up on the hill and is thinking in his mind of thinking about everything. So he was like that for a long, long time. Throughout most of his life, he was the Hermit, not on the outside, but on the inside in his mind, because he did have mental instability. We all know that. But what caused his mental instability was a chemical imbalance in his brain, okay? Low serotonin was one of them, plus a few other factors that made his brain unstable. But these are things that he never really understood. I'm sure the doctor did tell him about this kind of stuff. He was on medication. But for most of his life, he suffered from mental issues. Growing up, even as a teenager, as a child, growing up, he suffered from mental issues. And one of the reasons he became an actor, and he was so funny, and he would act out, that was his way of escaping his own self, his own mind, and, you know, the problems that he had within, that he kept secret for many, many years. He kept secret, you know, which caused him also a lot of depression, lots of depression. So, you know, as time went on and then his death came, you know, he thought about suicide for a while. It wasn't just on a whim, okay, I'm going to kill myself and then that's it. He thought about suicide for a while until finally he came to the decision to do it. So here, this is where his demise comes in. If I can pick up these cards. This is where it comes in and it shows, you know, his death. It's in the reverse and I'll tell you why, but this is literally mean death for him. Okay, now from here, the reading starts everything after his death. So after his death, this means that the situation that he was in goes on. Like what he's saying is that ending his life did not solve the problem. Okay, he just went from one place, dark place to another. I'm not saying he's in the dark, but he's not in the complete light either because he committed suicide. Most people, when they commit suicide, they don't go to heaven. Okay. Now, God's the only one that can judge us. So I'm not judging him or anything like that. But from all the experience that I have, I do know that you go to a waiting place after death until judgment day. And there's different levels according to how you lived your life. He was a very good man. He wasn't a bad man or anything like that, but he committed suicide. So that's a whole different story. You know, once you do that and cross over, you go to a dark place. Okay, so what this card represents here is that he's, you know, saying that the ending his life didn't help. It didn't help. It didn't end nothing for him. You know, the things that were in his mind are still there. It wasn't a solution is what he's saying. It wasn't a solution, you know. So it was pretty much a mistake is what he's saying. He made a mistake in his life. Okay, so here's his actual life. You know, in the upright, we all know this is success and travel. So, but when it's, you know, because horses mean movement. When it's in the reverse, there is no movement. Okay, so this, there's an infinity sign. Now it's in the reverse. So there is no happy travel, you know, travel through your life. You have the infinity sign. You live all the way through your life. Well, here there isn't none because it's in the reverse. Because of the decision he made, you know, his life ended. So this card is literally showing that his travel through life and his travel through ending his life was not successful. He thought that if he ends his life, okay, that'll be it. I'll be free. You know, in my mind, I'll be free. And I'll just be, you know, a happy spirit or whatever. But that did not come true. That did not come true. So it was the decision that he made to end his life was not successful. And here it is here. Okay. And he's also saying, I'm also hearing that his whole life he felt wasn't successful. Although he was successful as a movie star, you know, doing movies, making a lot of people happy and laugh. He feels like he wasn't successful in his own personal life, not as far as the movies is concerned, but his own personal life. He's feeling that he wasn't a successful person, like inside of his mind or in his own self. Now, here we have the Tower. This is literally the day that he committed suicide. So this is when it came. Okay. This is when he made the decision. It falls right under the Hermit. So this is the unexpected event, which is an unexpected event that we all experience with him. We all were completely shocked that, you know, he did that, and it created a huge unexpected event for everybody, even for himself, you know. Again, now here is, you know, this is the unexpected event, and then he laid himself to rest. Too tired. He was too tired to fight. This is a soldier that's laying here. The Four of Swords is a soldier that's laying here, that can't go on anymore, can't fight the battle anymore. You see in this picture, there's people praying for him even. But he lays down his sword here, and he has to lay down because he just can't fight the battle anymore. So this represents that he couldn't fight the battle of life anymore. He had to just lay down his life because it became too much for him in his mind, the thoughts that he was having. It's things that we're not going to understand because, you know, if we don't have any issues, then we're not going to understand that. Let me get a drink here. Okay, I love this cup. So, so he, you know, he made that decision, laid down his life, thought it was going to be, better, thought that would end everything, but it didn't, you know, because sometimes you carry that stuff with you in the afterlife. He can see the light sometimes is what I'm hearing, but not all the time. When people pray for him, he can see the light. So I suggest that everybody pray for him all the time. All the time. Okay, so here is, this is showing me that he was offered help from the universe, but he didn't accept that help. Now, what help it was, I don't know, but I do see that he was offered help while he was still here on Earth. He was offered help. Maybe it was the pills or maybe counseling or things like that. But there was a lot that he turned down that he didn't accept, you know, some of the help that was offered. There was different people at different times in his life, different doctors, you know, just different things throughout his life. Not just one time, but throughout his life where he was offered help and he didn't accept it. Okay, so that wasn't good for him. Now here he shows underneath the Tower. This is the Eight of Cups that he's leaving. And he thought, okay, again, this is the same thing as all these other ones, that if he ended his life, all these cups represent everything that meant something to him, his family, his home, his life, everything. He stacked them up, left them behind, and moved on to another, seeking something different. So he felt like if he ended his life, he would seek something different, that the afterlife could be so much better, would be so much better. So that's why he made that decision, because he was tired of everything. He left everything behind, just boom, gone, seeking for something else in the spirit world. But it shows here that that didn't come. That did not happen. That's why the death card is in the reverse. When it's in the reverse, that means whatever was going on is still going on. You're just in another place. It's still going on. It didn't end anything. It's going to go on and on and on. Okay. So what he wanted to achieve in the spirit world did not come. And in his life did not end the misery that he was in, because he just went from one misery to another. Okay, and it's very, very sad. Very sad, y'all. And again, y'all, this is alleged, because I am talking about another person. We were required to say that during YouTube. All the information comes from my tarot card, spirit guides, and my own psychic abilities. It does not reflect on my own personal feelings and thoughts about him, because I love him. I thought he was the greatest actor. He was so funny, you know. I'm going to pray for him often, and, you know, hope he, you know, has peace one day. Now, this is the card of childhood memories. So I feel like he thinks about that. He thinks about happier times. He wants to go back to happier times when he was a child. That's when he was the most happy, as an adult, or, you know, while he was acting and stuff like that. The most happiest was when he was very, very little and didn't really think about stuff. You know, when we're children, we don't really think about, oh, we got to pay bills and got to work and stuff like that. We're just happy-go-lucky kids, go outside and play, eat, and go to bed. Okay, so in his mind, and he often thinks about this as the olden times, because see, this is a picture of old, the olden times, and there's children here offering each other these cups. So he, in his mind, he goes back in and out a lot about those times. Those are the times that he was the happiest, when he was very, very small. Very small. And that's what he finds comfort in, is those memories. Because those are the only happy memories that he's ever had, actually. You know, we all see him as this happy person on TV, but we don't know what his private life was like. And most of it was misery for him because of the chemical imbalance in his brain that made him depressed, you know, off balance and stuff like that. So now we have the Two of Pentacles here. So this again is showing me balance, trying to balance. And I feel like he's saying that he tried really, really hard, you know, as hard as he could to balance things out, but everything was rocky for him. Here's the water in the back, which means unstable. His life was unstable, not as far as what we saw. Again, this is stressing this very, very much. Not what we saw. We saw him as a happy, rich actor. You know, made money and successful life, but in his own private mind and his own private self and his own private life, he never felt that. He never, ever felt that. He felt unsteady. His emotions were everywhere. He tried, again, we see the juggler here trying to balance, you know, and here's the infinity sign. He tried very hard to balance everything. He did make money because there's the coins, but even though the fact that he was rich, okay, money did not buy everything, is what he's saying. I'm hearing that right now. Money doesn't buy happiness. Okay. He was still his life was still very unsteady, and he tried very, very hard until he could not try anymore, until the day came that he decided that that was it. Okay. So I am going to end it here because, I feel this might probably be a part two to this, because I feel like he needs lots and lots of prayer, y'all. Please pray for him. Pray for his soul. Pray that he, you know, moves closer towards the light and gets out of the dark, moves closer towards the light. And, you know, that whatever went with him in his mind, that he can release that and be in peace. Okay? Everybody needs peace at one point. Okay? So, again, this is for Robin Williams, the great famous actor that ended his life. I give him much respect because I loved him. I loved him. My favorite movie that he made was Mrs. Doubtfire. I just love that movie. It's an old movie, and I still watch it. I have that video. I still have it, and I watch it sometimes. But, yeah, so please pray for him. May he rest in peace and find peace, you know, and I hope that he sees God one day. I'm going to end it here, y'all. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you'll be reminded when I upload another video. See you next time. Bye-bye.